and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to go over the West Coast Classic style. Now the West Coast Classic style comes really down to sound selection. So once you have sound selection down, you pretty much are going to have an easy time getting into the West Coast style. So firstly, we want to start with a nice saw bass. This can also be a lead as well. And we treat it just like the sine wave for R&B. It could be a sub bass or it could be a high pitch lead. So we're going to use a saw bass here in 3X OSC. You know, it's just a basic one voice saw. Turn off oscillator 2 and 3. And we're going to switch the waveform to a sawtooth. And I'm going to play really low octaves for the bass. Okay, and now one more function I want is portamento bend. So I'm going to go to the wrench tool, turn on portamento in monophonic mode. So that means when I overlap notes, it pitch bends between the notes. So there's a small little time difference there between the notes. So I'm going to go boom, boom, boom. So first I want to tap out the tempo. So right about 90, 92. And a lot of West Coast stuff uses pitch bends on their bass. Let me turn this down first. So I'm first going to write out a nice bass line that I have in my head. So we're playing it like it's a real bass. And you want to think of a lot of pitch bends. So I want to go dun, dun. So instead of changing the notes, I want to go bun. So I'm going to overlap the notes. And because we have portamento on, it's going to pitch bend. Make sure you pitch bend to the next note within the scale so it sounds decent. So it goes dun, dun. By itself, again, because of what's called portamento. And because we have it on monophonic mode. So that means it will only play one voice at a time, but it will also pitch bend. So I'm going to go boom. So I'm going to go down an octave, make this half the time of the other note, and just double click. In FL Studio, you can turn it to a slide note. In other DAWs, you just place the note here. And because you have portamento on, it's going to pitch bend from D to D in a lower octave. You can even go to a lower octave. So ba ba na na da ba ba. And then it's going to repeat. Now, what I might want to do is pull these down an octave. So that's going to drive the motion for the bass. Let's just add that into the playlist. And I'm going to boost up a couple points in that sound. I might just turn it up in volume. Now it's okay that it's so bright, but you can also muffle the brightness with an EQ using it as a filter, switching this to a low-pass filter if it's too much brightness in the tone. So that's going to be the basis of our song. And let's go to FM8 now. We're going to pull up under the browser. We're going to go to, instead of the sounds tab, let's go to the instruments tab. Let's go to pianos. And I'm going to look through their pianos. A lot of these are e-pianos and they sound really good. So let's just cycle through the pianos. Going to record that as a background element. It sounds really cool. So not only am I going to have an e-piano that does chords, I'm going to have one that just does like a lead function. and this is what I'm doing now. It's not for chords. Just following the scale. So I know it's going to be a little bit off because of the recording delay, which is fine. So I'm going to hit Control A, Alt Q to quantize all those notes. And you can also hit Alt L to drag out the notes or articulate the notes to fill in all the dead space. So that's an FL Studio shortcut. But what you're doing is just making sure the notes are quantized and filled in all the gaps. Now for this sound, I want it to kind of live on a little bit. So I'm going to add a reverb so it feels like it's in a room. So let's add a fruity reverb too. I'm going to make it stereorized. So it feels almost like a guitar, the way it's being played. Let's open up another FM8 and let's load up another e-piano. So let's go to instruments. Pianos, and again, they have really nice e-pianos. Do a double lead, so that sounds really cool, playing those kind of contrast to each other. Then I'm going to have another e-piano do the chords. So this is really unique. I don't use counter melodies as much, but here's a situation where we're going to use them. So one's going down the scale, another one's kind of playing up the scale and then coming back down, so they match in energy. Let me figure out where I want to start here. Start there. Let's record that. Now the ending got a little sloppy, so I might redo that because I hit the wrong note and it threw me off. So let's try that one more time. I usually just stick with it, but for this one, I have a better idea. So that's the main part. That came out a little bit better than the other one, so I'm going to keep that take. I'm just going to quantize, hitting Alt Q. And let's turn this down so we can balance the two. I'm going to have one pan left, one pan right, so we can hear them distinctly. I can see a note off the grid, so I'm going to fix this here. Let me fix the timing here because it's a little off. Okay, so now we have those. Let's move to our fourth e-piano. So the West Coast classic style depends on what mood you're going for, but it's really focused around e-pianos, and FM8 has really nice e-pianos. This is almost like a secret stash of e-pianos. So I usually don't let out my secret stashes, but this is one of those overlooked things. And FM8, if you go to instruments and pianos, they have really, really nice retro-sounding pianos. Like this one. That one's cool. I'm going to cycle through to figure out which one sounds good for chords. We're probably going to use another EP for this one. I just played. I'm playing this. So that's what I'm playing. I'm going to record that just by itself in its own pattern. So a lot of it is just strumming notes to make it sound nice and R&B-esque. So I'm just going to drag the notes over instead of quantizing. I'm going to delay them a bit because I know they're a little off the grid. I'm going to pull these down an octave. Maybe another octave. It's a little too low. Let's try another octave. So I'm going to add these in for rhythm. So I might cut it. Let's have it evolve over time so it's not just the same thing over and over. So I have the one piano play for half and the other one play for the second half. How we didn't even start with the drums yet. But now here we're going to add the drums. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Now they're in the free virus kit at busyworksbeats.com/virus. We offer drums and another free course. I'm going to load up the drums from that package here called the virus drum kit because I have some West Coast drums in here under one of the projects. So let's see. Take it off auto mode. So some car effects if you want. See what else we can grab. Kicks are going to be pretty hype to match that kind of chord energy. So I was like, I want to sing along as we go so it makes sense with the drums. I'm going to delay the snare a bit. So you can either do boom, clap, boom, boom, clap, or you can do boom, clap, ba-boom, clap. Those are usually the West Coast rhythms. I think the boom. I think that works better. I rid of that little tail in the beginning because that might be holding up the time here. So let me get rid of that initial silence because that's all it is. Silence. Let's zoom out a bit because we don't want any delays in this kick. I wanted to hit right on the downbeat. West Coast, it's common to have the snare louder than the kick. I want to have the kick have priority here. Let's create another saw lead. You might want to add is vibrato, but you want it to come in over time. So for example, go to your envelopes, go to pitch, turn on your LFO on a sine wave motion, turn the amount up very subtle, because that's what it sounds like when you have it when the amount's too high. You just want vibrato, which is slight pitch change. Now the speed, we're gonna make it faster, but lower the amount. And what we want to do here is increase the attack. So it takes longer for that to kick in. So after I hit a key, you don't hear it for a while. So it's like a natural vibrato effect. You could also detune the sound. But it takes away from that kind of classic sound. So I'm just going to add little flares of that in the main verse section. Record that. There was a flaw in there because I was using my left hand, not paying attention, but it's fine. We're just going to leave it as is, just to show you that you can add that in as well as a lead. Again, you might want to move the MIDI to the right a little bit, just to delay it a little bit. So right here we had a flaw. Not control down, let's hit shift down. I want to make the volume more constant. I don't want all those volume jumps, so I'm just going to right click the velocity and drag it across evenly. So I wanted to go. And I'm going to pan this to the right so it's balancing out with the darker sound to the left. Remember that I have it for the one section here, so I'm going to get rid of that and then have them both play but with the other lead instead of our lead. So I'm switching out the leads basically. Symbol activity in here. count. Let's just fill it in for each two steps. Let the beat kind of build into the hi-hat rhythm. See, it's a little too early, so let's go to the wrench tool. Turn up that time shift until it fits the groove. A lot of people just leave it locked in and it sounds really awful. Also add strings for that West Coast vibe. I'm not gonna add strings for this tutorial video. And I'm gonna omit the leads. We're just gonna leave the chords. The video, I'm gonna hook up my guitar and then we're gonna record the guitar live, and then I might do the vocoder just to see. We'll see. So let's move on to the next section here. So in part two, what I'm gonna do is add the guitar, just little, you know, things here and there, just things like that. I'm not gonna overly do it with guitar chords and all that. So let's just make sure we have our guitar, which is track 16, armed for recording. Before you hit record, I'm going to hit record and hit audio into playlist. It's going to automatically start the countdown, and I'm just going to play as we go along. So let's hit audio into playlist. I'm going to do multiple takes and multiple times. Trying to nail.
mess up every now and then. That was a good take. And I can add delay to it. Take the good parts. I mean, you could chop and piece. You could chop the pieces you like. Let's move into the next section so I can take this guitar out.
So now the next step is to process the guitar. Now I'm not going to process it heavily. I'm just going to add delay and maybe reverb to certain sections, not all sections. I only want it to have delay on certain sections. So I'm going to pick the good takes, chop out the rest, and we're going to figure out how to move those pieces around to make it really fit in the song. That take was a little too early, so that wasn't even, you know, a take that's probably our best take, that first take, so we can get rid of that. And remember, this is an audio clip, so we need to send it to the mixer. And also, I like to normalize, make it louder. That was a good down guitar hit, so let's just solo that. What I like to do is cut out all the excess and just trim it and then slice it at the very end. You hear it's a little early, so I'm gonna go to snap to grid none and we're gonna manually move this waveform to the right just a little bit because right now it's earlier than the drop. I want it a little delayed from the metronome. And I also wanted to go boom, boom, boom. So I want to have a delay effect. Let's open up Fruity Delay. Turn it on ping pong mode. I want it to hit every four steps. So it goes one, two, three, four. That's nice. I'm just going to turn down the input volume a little bit. That just adds a little more rhythm to the ear. For the ear to catch on. Now what I'm going to do here is actually right click and create automation clip for the delay because I don't want the delay on all the time. I only want it on for certain sections. I think that was an okay turnaround, but slice it, again get rid of the excess. And I wanted to slice it again to the right side and then move the audio to the right because it's a little early. So these are the small things you're going to be doing with audio clips. Now, if you don't want to stretch the audio, make sure when you have audio clips highlighted for your focus, take off stretch because stretching will change the pitch and the way it's perceived. I just want to get rid of the, I want to trim the silence. And again, I want that delay here, so let's add that in. Add the delay right here. You can turn it on beat mode or whatever you want to do to get really precise. I don't want that first hit to be delayed. I want just the downbeat to be delayed. So that's why we have an automation clip for the delay. But that was a practice run and I don't like that. So I'm going to get rid of that. And use my first downbeat hit. Make sure I'm on bar mode. I'm going to grab my pencil tool, hit shift, and drag it over. Again, I want delay on that downbeat, so I'm going to let that ride out. Let's hear what this is here. That was a bad practiced turnaround. So I'm going to get rid of that. And again, we're just going to keep duplicating the good downbeat take with the delay. So that's all we have to do. And I'm just looking for the area where I had that nice, you know, that kind of multiple note turnaround. That was good. It's just a little off the grid, so I need to line it up with the grid. So let's go to snap to grid, none, zoom in, and line it up with the grid. It was good up until the down hit. So I'm gonna keep this stuff, but I'm gonna get rid of the down hit and then clone our good down hit. So you can see how much work goes into, you know, live audio takes. It's not just perfect recording as you go. You kind of work, you make it perfect as you go. And again, you can see here, I didn't delay that area because I don't want that to get too tangled up in delay. I'm gonna slice off the excess. And that was that was a mistake. So what I'm gonna do is just clone that over. And again, add the delay here for just the downbeat. The timing of that, because it sounds more natural with everything kind of flowing. So that one's good. I'm just going to add delay on the downbeat. Now, does this mean I want this whole section to be filled with those turnaround areas? Not necessarily. You know, you could spend more time on arrangement. I'm just kind of showing you how to pick and choose and keep moving. I would probably have these dun, 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 during the hook. I'm not sure where the hook is, probably around this area since everything's here. Messed up. So what I'm going to do is transplant that boom going up the scale from a different area, and that will be our hook area, this whole kind of meaty area around here. So we have that nice turnaround guitar take, and we can do that up until the end where I'm going to have that scale ascendance. Where is it? I think it's right here. So I'm going to grab that from the end. Again, slice, and then we're just gonna transplant by changing our snap to grid to bar. I'm gonna grab it, hit shift to duplicate it, and I'm gonna pull it over towards wherever we are. Let's see. I'm gonna slice it right at that last note because you can hear the string was getting muted at a certain point. So I'm going to grab again our good old friend, the good guitar take for the downbeat. Grab that over here and then add that delay. So you can see how when you do live recordings, you might have to move stuff around. This is what arrangement is all about. And again, it's a little early, so let's zoom in. I'm not going to spend too much time on the guitar. I just wanted to show you that those sections. Slide this over a bit more. And just how guitar can really add life to your track. So it goes beyond the DAW. You might have to record a vocal, a guitar, something to go over the track. It will add a new dimension. Now the rest of these I'm probably gonna get rid of. I might leave a couple of these. Like that was a cool turnaround. And I'm gonna add that delay just like before. Now I'm not gonna have downbeats. I'm not gonna have the guitar on every downbeat like we did before. I'm gonna kind of lax on the verse area. I'm only gonna leave the cool little licks that I've recorded improv style. So wherever it is, that's where it stays. I'm not gonna move it around like we did with the hook area. And I also like that I hit the wrong key. but it sounds really good here. So I'm glad it happened the way it did. I like that little. Where it goes, I didn't mean to do that. That was not too interesting, so I'm going to cut it out. That was pretty good, so I'm going to leave it in. So wherever, you know, wherever the soul was going, I'm just going to leave it there. Actually add, let's see, I'm going to change this to beat mode, and we're going to add the automation here as well on that note before the drop, so it delays both of those. And you can probably hear the delay cut off. That's because I didn't draw the automation out long enough. So you want to make sure you draw out the automation for the amount of time you want the delay to last. And I accidentally cut out the. For those vertical lines, I'm holding shift while I'm slicing, by the way. So if you hold shift, you won't get those kind of crooked lines. If you hold shift, you get a nice vertical slice. Rid of that last bar. There you have it, how to add guitar to your West Coast track. Now let's hear this track with the guitar. Then I'll turn off the guitar and we're gonna hear the difference. That is how you create a West Coast classic track. It all comes down to sound selection, and once you have the right sound selection, you'll be good. with your guidance through your music production. And hopefully we helped you today. If you want to learn more about music theory, which is what made this track stand out, you want to go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. You can click that link below to get started now and learn more about chord progressions, melody, song structure, scales, how they all go together, fifths, the circle of fifths, circle of fourths, a lot of different things you can learn if you click that link below. Thanks for watching. It's busyworksbeats.com.